Act One of Pygmalion in Covent Garden, a district of London, a torrent of rain sends people hurrying for shelter under the portico of St. Paul's Church. Among them are a finely dressed lady and her daughter, who have been to the theater and now seek a taxi to take them home. Another is a man writing in a notebook. The lady's son, Freddie, rushes in, saying no cabs are available. Impatiently, his mother sends him back out to try again. As he sets off, he runs right into a dirty, disheveled girl selling flowers, sending her flower basket flying. He apologizes and dashes off, leaving her to pick up scattered flowers. Despite the objections of the lady's daughter, the lady pays the girl for the two bunches of ruined violets. Then, an elderly gentleman dressed in evening clothes hurries in out of the rain and pauses near the flower girl, who tries to sell him some flowers. He gives the girl 3 halfpence, or half pennies, and walks off. A bystander warns the girl that there's a man eavesdropping and taking down her every word. He may be a detective. Panicked that she will be accused of soliciting for prostitution, the girl hysterically confronts the note taker, who dismisses her fear, saying, "Oh, shut up, shut up. Do I look like a policeman?" Bystanders erupt in defense of the frightened girl, and things get a little hostile. Well, the note taker begins identifying where various speakers come from based on their speech. But tensions ease when the note taker turns his trick on the elderly gentleman and then on the lady and her daughter. The note taker brags to the elderly gentleman that he could make a duchess of the flower girl by teaching her to speak properly. Then the rain stops and nearly everyone disperses. Only the elderly gentleman, note taker, and flower girl remain. The men, it turns out, share a common interest in language and have been intending to seek each other out. The elderly gentleman is Colonel Pickering, a student of Indian dialects and the author of Spoken Sanskrit. The gentleman is Professor Henry Higgins, author of Higgins' Universal Alphabet. Higgins invites Pickering around to his home the next day, and the two men depart for a chat over some supper. Higgins tosses a handful of coins in the flower girl's basket as he leaves. It's a fortune by her standards. When Freddie pulls up in a taxi for his mother and sister, who have taken the bus, she takes it off his hands and heads home in style. Act One introduces the play's 3 main characters, establishes the central premise of the play, and provides social context for the events that will unfold.